Welcome to AlphaFold model prediction in Phenix. This tutorial describes how to run AlphaFold protein structure prediction through the Phenix GUI. Phenix now includes tools that integrate AlphaFold prediction into the structure determination workflows for both X-ray crystallography and cryo-EM. In this video, we will do a short walkthrough of the structure prediction tool, which can be a very useful first step for any structural biology project. The innovation of AlphaFold, as well as many other recent prediction tools, has been to use advances in machine learning to learn from the vast amount of information stored in the protein databank. These machine learning models find a way to accurately generate protein structures from a primary sequence without explicitly understanding the underlying physical processes. To run the structure prediction tool, select the AlphaFold top-level category in the Phenix GUI. It is worth mentioning that there is a prominent Help button, which will open the Phenix documentation in a web browser. This is another useful resource. Next, choose AlphaFold model prediction. This opens the Input and Settings dialog. We will first give the job a title. Next, we have the option of uploading files. For example, a FASTA-format sequence file. Alternatively, we could simply copy and paste the sequence into the Sequence Input box. I will paste a sequence in to demonstrate. Next, we will move to the second tab, Prediction and Building Settings. In this tab, we can customize options such as the number of predicted models, whether or not to use templates from the PDB, and whether or not to perform a multiple sequence alignment to use as input for the prediction. Generally, each of these options will improve the accuracy of your prediction, so by default, they are selected. Because of the computational demands of running AlphaFold, the actual computations will occur on a GPU machine maintained by the Phenix developers. Your files will be uploaded, your data will be processed, and the result will be sent back to you. Each of these steps should happen automatically within the Phenix job. Keep in mind that this will require an active internet connection to access the remote computing resources. This checkbox enables returning pre-calculated results. If the box is enabled and your protein sequence has been used for a previous job with the same parameters, it will send that result to you without doing a new prediction. This mode gives you an answer quickly, but if you do want a unique AlphaFold run, you can disable this option. If the Allow Pre-calculated Multiple Sequence Alignment checkbox is selected, then the Phenix server will use a pre-calculated sequence alignment if your sequence has been run before. For this demonstration, I will leave all the settings at default and select Run. The job starts and some logging is visible. To view the number of other users on the Phenix server, the Server button at the top right displays a status window. If there are many active jobs, you may have to wait longer for your job to run. When the job completes, a summary window will display the resulting files. By scrolling down, some information about the PLDDT is presented. This is an assessment of AlphaFold's confidence in the accuracy of the structure. The PLDDT value of 97.91 is very high, indicating that this structure has been predicted with very high confidence. Below that is the PAE plot, which stands for Predicted Aligned Error. This gives you some insight into AlphaFold's confidence of pairwise residue orientations. If your protein has multiple distinct domains, this is often apparent by looking at the PAE plot. This PAE plot does not show any domains. Here is what a plot would look like with multiple domains. Note that the bright green rectangles indicate that pairs of residues within each rectangle have accurate relationships, and those between rectangles do not. Finally, I will use the Chimera X button to open Chimera X and examine the predicted structure. We can see that it looks like a well-folded protein to the eye. If we then overlay the true structure obtained from experiment, we can see the ribbon representations align quite well. By switching to an atom view, we can see that the prediction is still very similar to the experimental model, but not exactly. Some residues and some loops have visible differences. In general, AlphaFold predicted this chain quite accurately, and this predicted model would be a very useful input for other Phenix tools. For example, molecular replacement or real space refinement with a cryo-EM map. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you have any questions, please contact us at help@phoenix-online.org.